Rohini is one of the most popular faculty members in the finance department, known for her in-class engagement with students. Every year, she offers an elective financial risk and derivatives management in the fourth term, which gets subscribed by about 100 students, ostensibly a good teacher. This year, owing to COVID-19, she's forced to teach the course online, that too in the fifth term. Not only format is different, it's also deferred. The fifth term is notorious for its non-negotiable teaching slots. To enable her teaching, Rohini uses her favorite laptop, Maple Book Lite, sold by Maple. Nice, very innovative name. Rohini converts her family bedroom into a working room because of the strong Wi-Fi signals. Yeah. Wi-Fi signals matter more than family bonds. The room is mostly used by Rohini for taking her classes. However, Rinku, her husband, also uses it for running his meetings. Rohini has two children, aged 5 and 8, who use the living room as their playground. I've seen that happen. It's a complete nightmare. During meetings and classes, the working room is shut to save it from unwanted disturbance and noises from the living room. It is 3:10 p.m. and Rohini's penultimate session of the course is going to end in 20 minutes. As usual, Rinku enters the room with a cup of Darjeeling tea. Just before entering, he asks his kids to stop playing for some time. He quietly places the tea cup on Rohini's study table and exits the room, leaving the door ajar. As soon as he leaves, a tennis ball comes thundering inside, crashing into her Maple Book monitor. The monitor breaks and Rohini's class ends abruptly, much before scheduled time. It's a tragedy, but a first world tragedy. I mean, there's far more worse things that can happen than a monitor crashing and a class getting canceled. It's not the end of the world. It's one of our daily challenges of living in any community setting, but particularly so with families and young children. This is something waiting to happen. I read this case and said, "Chaos, man! What is there? This whole thing, and we call it Tuesday. And that's all it is. I mean, this happens every other week in every other household. Something gets broken because one door was left ajar, and it's a non-event. But still, let's see whether the questions make it spice it up in some form. What should be best held responsible for the accident? Right, so I wouldn't hold anything responsible for the accident. Right, so. But look at this. The kid's not checking the door before resuming play. They're 5 and 8. They're not going to do that. Right? COVID-19 imprisoning Rohini and her children in a closeted space. Yeah. That's a thing for me. Rinku Singh leaving the door ajar. Yeah, that's a problem. He came and gave the tea. But when he gave the tea, he said, as usual, Rinku enters the room with a cup of Darjeeling tea. As usual, this is his usual thing. And he comes and leaves the tea. He asks his kids to stop playing. He quietly places the teacup on Rohini's study table. So he's being a nice guy. Still 20 minutes to go. She's probably tired after a long class. Good time to have a tea. All good. The only mistake he does is he leaves the door ajar. He shouldn't have. As soon as he leaves, a tennis ball comes thundering inside, crashing into it. So it's not like it's a crime. You must keep in mind that I've been Rinku Singh on several interviews. I'm obviously going to look at this and say that's not a crime. So Rinku Singh leaving the door ajar, it's a problem, but I don't think it's such a big deal. Rinku Singh not waiting for the class to get over before serving tea. This is not an issue because it's very clear. It's as usual. This is a usual thing. This happens every day, 20 minutes, half an hour before things. So he makes his tea. The class is continuing, but he camps and comes and drops a tea and heads out. Not waiting for the class to end, that's not a big deal. Keeping the door ajar, that's an issue. This is a mistake. And so, Rohini not locking the door from inside during class hours. So she doesn't want any interruption. So she should take care of her own plans and make sure that it's rigid to not take chances. The answer which is given is this. I was not super convinced. I went for B. I said, look, this is just the world we are living in. This is not somebody's fault. This is just that we live in this world. Children are there. It's bound to happen. It's not the end of the world. Roll with it. A class, B's minute cut. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. We'll fix something or just get on with it. This is the time we are living in. I'm sure even the students wouldn't have been too offended. They can imagine a tennis ball coming and hitting. It's not a crucial fact. We just have a good laugh about it and brush it aside. So I more or less jumped and went for this. But the right answer choice is this, which is one thing, which a big message from the guys who set the paper, saying, look, whenever who should be assigned this, then there is about personal accountability, and you can't blame someone else. You can't blame people who don't have the ability and power to do it, not the children. You can't blame circumstance. So get out of the habit of saying, he screwed it up for me, they messed it up for me, the virus killed it for me. Transition to saying, look, I should have been more careful. That's perhaps a message from BDM, basically saying, hey, something goes wrong, look for what you could have changed. That's the thing you should have changed. Control what you can control. So therefore, this is the answer choice that's given. So more than just this question in another context, I'm still going for this. But the learning that I had from this one is to say, don't blame someone else. Don't blame people who are powerless. Don't blame situation. Don't blame fate, circumstance. See what you could have done. And that perhaps something that's crucial in answering these kind of questions. Not saying I will do it. I'm still inclined to blame something else. Rohini has a concluding session scheduled for the very next day. Which of the following is the best course of action for Rohini regarding the final session? She should inform the student that the course is deemed concluded with 19 sessions. Not such a big fan of this. I'll tell you, you plan for 19 sessions, that's all right. You plan at 15 sessions that it's going to be only 19 and you rejig, that's all right. It's an abrupt end, even the 19th session has not ended. I have 20 in mind, I have plenty to say. I usually have plenty to say in the last thing, hey, goodbye, best wishes. Take care of that. I don't want to just say, okay, class khatam, your batch is done, you go do what you want to do. Not such a big fan of that choice. She should defer the session until she finds a suitable slot. Yeah, possible. You go for this. But if it was slot number 12, 13, I would have liked it. Because then there are 8 more classes, 7 more classes. Then I can always figure out a day where I can do a double slot and figure it out. But this is not, this is the last session. And quite possibly there are exams after this and there are other things on their plate after this. So I would worry a little bit, but that's an option, definitely. A, less so, B, definitely. She should take her last session on her mobile phone and request students to tolerate the inferior experience. Yeah, easy fix. I like that. Take it on the mobile and say, look, so these are COVID times. I can't go and fix my laptop. Not possible. This is the circumstance we have been dealt. Let's make our peace with it and finish it. It's not going to be the best thing, but 95% of the course is done. Last 5%, I wanted to have this thing where we gathered our thoughts, told you about the final exam, discussed a bunch of things and say a goodbye after that. The phone should work. So I like that choice. She should cancel the session and ask students to mail video presentations on the topic she intended to teach, which is very much like A. Say that effectively saying the course is already over. I don't want to do that. I have a schedule, I have a plan, I want to stick to it. I want to take every effort to stick to it. So I'm not such a big fan of D either, very similar to A. She should request Swarna, her colleague, to take her session the next day. This is possible. I would have even thought about this more seriously if it had not been the last session and under time pressure. Swarna might be my cousin and she might know what I'm doing. Not cousin, colleague, sorry. She might know what I'm doing, but I can't transition that level of knowledge in one day, especially for the last session. If I were a teacher, if I were a faculty running 20 classes, and my last class schedule for the last day, and I want to be there for the last session. If I'm not there, I'm taking a weekend off on November 14th, and there's one topic that I know anybody can handle. And then I say, hey, November 14th, Swarna, why don't you step in for me? Just take this class. And she'll probably say, glad to help out. And that's all right. There's a planned handing over. But this will look like a fudged finish. I don't want to do that. Choice C it is, because it is the last class. With the sixth term around the corner, Rohini goes to the Maple Service Center only to find that the replacement for her crash monitor may take several weeks. The supply chain disruptions worldwide. However, Dhanraj, the service center head, offers to replace the damaged monitor with a monitor from a used laptop. Nice guy, he gives it a fix. He assures Rohini that the used monitor is as good as a new one. Nice. Which of the following options, if true, will give Rohini the best reason to accept the offer? So, he's saying, look, naya monitor to anine wala. Please take this, manage it for the time being. We'll get it fixed. I have this. So whenever somebody says this, handle this, then I want to be able to kind of trust their judgment. That they know what they're doing. And I want to be able to trust them. Okay, he has my best interest at heart. And so So the Dhanraj should be a guy who knows his stuff and the guy whom I can trust. Rohini is a long time customer of the Maple store, which runs the service center. I like that. She's been there, she's long term. So you're long term customer, it automatically means that you like the guys. It's not just you've been there for a long time. You've been there for a long time. There's a level of trust and confidence you have in the system. Being a long term customer comes with it. It puts a lot of ticks along with it. Her husband's meeting will be fewer and far between in the next few weeks. This is fine, but I would have loved it if it had, if it were true. Then I can probably use his laptop. So I don't think it's a direct thing for my own problem. Maybe he has a laptop, I can use it, he doesn't have too many meetings, I can live with it. So I'm not such a big fan of this because it doesn't give, expand on. And if he has fewer meetings, then I can use his laptop, then I can wait for the other thing. So it's the exact opposite. I shouldn't be taking a replacement one. Dhanraj is a friend of Rohini's colleague Swarna. Good, interesting. And Dhanraj is a friend. That means he comes with a certain automatic endorsement. But being a long time customer is a bigger endorsement than this. Several times, friends of friends have even let me down service wise. You get into the relationship because there's a certain trust and you like the guy and they look to me, I'll give him business. But being a long term customer is a ringing endorsement of the trust and confidence you have in that. Being friend of a friend, less so. Dhanraj offers a 3-month personal assurance on the use monitor. Nice, this is good. He basically says, you take my word for it, this will work. Right? Rohini has to start her 6-term course in a month. This is important. This says that she needs to have a fix. She can't wait for the replacement monitor to arrive. She needs to have a fix straight away. So it is between A, D and E, very tight. B and C we can eliminate. A, D, E. This says she has pressure. She can't wait for the replacement monitor, whether it's used monitor or some other fix that we don't know. The problem is when I get a proposition, some idea like this from someone, right? You use this, then I'm saying, okay, this can work for 3 months or 2 months, or I can use this replacement piece. And my decision will be nudged towards that with more confidence I have in that decision rather than the pressure I'm in. So this is the pressure I'm in that is nudging me towards some decision. But unless I'm very sure about what the new replacement offering is, I shouldn't be going for it. Very often I've taken poor decisions because I've been driven by this and not by the merits of the issue in hand. I don't know if I'm coming through very clearly on this. So I'll go there and I'll feel like, look, we need to take a decision in 4 weeks. And that pressure drives decision making rather than evaluating that product on its own merit. So that rush or haste or slight bit of element of hurry sometimes messes up decision making, which is why I'm not such a big fan of. You should evaluate this proposal on its own merit rather than being driven by other pressures that I have. It's a very tough call between A and D. D may, he gives a personal assurance. Now, he giving me assurance, there are two parts here. He should say this will work, take my word for it. One, before that, I should trust. I should automatically understand that he knows his stuff. I should have a relationship with him. So if you go to a shop which you've been going for 5 years and that guy says, "Ho jayega, le lo." Even if he doesn't give a personal guarantee, I'll take it. But then I suddenly go to a new place and they said, "Just you don't worry about it. I give you my personal guarantee, 4 months it will be there." I don't know that guy. His personal guarantee is worth nothing. Which is why A is better. With this one thing, long time customer, when you're dealing with a vendor, you've had a long relationship with them, certain attributes of trust and confidence and reliability get built in. It's already there. That I know that this guy won't sell me a dummy just because he wants to make a quick buck or make some money somewhere. So I won't go for D, I'll prefer A, because A ratifies that Dhanraj for me in ways that D cannot. D tells me that Dhanraj makes a promise. A tells me that Rohini trusts Dhanraj, which is why I like A better than D. A it is.